Alright guys, we are back here for another episode. Please make sure to drop a like and subscribe down below. If you haven't seen the last episode guys, there is a card down below. Please make sure to check that out. That was a really nice little episode. And we're back here for another episode of the classic RTG. It is going really, really nice and smoothly. And by the end of this episode, we will have a full silver team, obviously other than Cork. And a nice premium bronze bench, which is going to really fill up. And nice load of premium bronze actually on the bench, just in case we get a couple of injuries popping up. And as you can see on the screen right now, we're going to go and look at getting a brand new goalkeeper. The other goalkeeper we've got at the moment, he has not been bad at all, Mr. Wright. But we need to start really getting a lot more quality into the team. We go and pick up Bun. He looks like one of the best non-rares in the Premier League. I know he plays for Aston Villa, which doesn't bloody help, but he looks like a beast of a goalkeeper, and he'll do us really nicely. We also go and pick up another player. We pick up a midfielder, centre midfielder. We go and pick up Mr. Drinkwater. He looks like a bit of a beast at the moment for Leicester City. They are playing so, so well, Leicester City, guys. Please drop a like down below, guys, if you're going to enjoy this episode, and if you're actually enjoying the series. But also, please comment down below, guys, what you think about Leicester City overall, how you think they're going in this bloody Premier League at the moment. They are killing it. We're also going to pick up a left midfielder, Stanislas. Doesn't look like the best left midfielder in the world for a normal rare silver, but he looks alright. He doesn't look too bad at all, and he gets a handy little midfielder, left midfielder, to put into the team. And that is the full team already up and running, guys. I thought, you know what, let's get these silvers in there, and let's get into a couple of games and see how they do. So we go and put Barker on the bench, put a load of other players on the bench. And it's, the bench is looking quite nice. We're filling them up really nicely. And that's the team overall, guys. So it's not too bad at all. I feel like swapping over Campbell and Riviera, they look to be like an absolute tank of a partnership. And hopefully the more we get into the series, the more the RTG gets longer and longer, we're going to be coming across some really nice little teams on the actual on the video at the moment. So Riviera and Fraser Campbell, hopefully they can provide for us. This is the team we come across, a really nice looking MLS side, looks really, really good this year. I tell you what guys, check out the MLS this year, because they've got one hell of a squad. I mean, look at this, Pirlo, Gerrard, Lampard, Kamara, not sure who that left mid is, not sure who that right mid is. I think that was Siman in centre back, a really, really fast centre back from Belgium. And I think that was Opar, one of the fastest actual centre backs in the actual game, and one of the best premium silvers in the game. And I think that was, I'm not sure it was in the goal, it might have been Howard actually. But overall, the team we came across was really, really nice. The game itself, it was a really tough one. I mean, he scores here, it's a nice goal by him. Not sure who that is who scored there, but it was a nice little goal, nicely worked. And I've got to give him that, it was a nice goal. That's right, Mr. Frank Lampard did score that one, guys. And it was a nice little goal. But there you go, connection lost. That's about 20th minute into the game. And we've already lost connection, so I don't know what happened there. I am quite chuffed because I had a feeling we were going to... It was going to be a really tough game, and I had a feeling we were going to lose that one because he was just so, so strong in that midfield. Pirlo, Gerrard and bloody Lampard. What a hell of a midfield that is. I mean, it's very, very old, but I tell you what, they've still got it in them, fellas. I mean, they're about 34, 35, even 36, a lot of them now and then. But overall, we played all right. But we didn't see too much of that, obviously, because of the connection. So I am sorry about that one, guys, but I thought I'd put it in there anyway. Just, I don't know, get a game in there. So we get into another game here, and it's a nice BBVA he's got here. Petroriak, Rakitic. I don't know who that set other cinema is. I think that's, yeah, Koke, that's right. We had Konopli anchor up front. He had Gamiro, in form Gamiro, Carlos Vela, and, yeah, obviously a nice team overall, BBVA. So we're coming across some really, really strong teams in Division 9. I don't know how the hell that's working out, because Division 9 has never been that strong when it comes to these sort of teams. I mean, that team we just came across, you're looking at about, not much, but you're not looking at much money, but it's such a strong-looking team. He does have a free kick there, hits the crossbar, which was a pain in the bloody ass, because it was just showing the pressure he was putting on us. We had a nice chance there, hits it straight at the bloody keeper. Once again, we break through, and it's a lovely, lovely finish. Really, really nice finish by Mr. Riviera. What a signing he is. He's going to be getting more goals, hopefully, in the next couple of episodes, guys, and more games, because this guy can finish his potatoes. And what a finish it was. Nice little finish in the bottom left-hand corner. We had a couple more chances, but he didn't take all of them. But this one, he absolutely buries it past the goalkeeper. And I'm really chuffed with that, because this team we were coming across was really, really solid when it came to attack. Honestly, when he came attacking with Inform Gamero, Knopfli Anchor on the left, and Carlos Fire, he was killing me. He kept him taking the left and the right edges all the time and trying to whip it in for Gamero. Or he tried to go in with the midfield and try and loop over the top from one of the midfielders onto Gamero to run straight through. But he does give us a penalty there. Big Fraser Campbell stepping up very, very nicely there. And yeah, hopefully we can put this in the back of the net and see what happens. Oh, it's a lovely little finish up this for Fraser Campbell. He gets another goal. This striking partnership, guys, is unbelievable. Scoring a nice load of goals with these fellas. Can we keep it going? That's the question. I'm hoping next episode or next couple more matches we can really carry on firing these ballers into the back of the net. And overall, we are playing really, really well. The team is gelling really nicely. We're getting quite a few English players in there, which is really, really helping there. He gets a chance there, just not enough on it. Comes off the post, comes off the crossbar, and we put that away. And we have another chance here. I'm not sure who had that one, not too sure at all actually, but it was a nice little finish there and a nice bit of keeping there. But overall, what a win it was, 2-1, just what we needed. That is what we need, an absolute boost and a half for our division hopes and trying to get promotion. So I know all we need now is another win and we're out of relegation in this division. But what a win it was. It's just brilliant to see that we're getting wins against these sort of teams. Like, what a solid team he had, and what a win it was. The left and right backs, I think it was just the right back actually, really good little performance by him there, really showing us why he wants to stay in the team. But I also want to have a little statement out there to Mr. Bunn, guys. Mr. Bunn, the goalkeeper, what a performance he had. I know we didn't see all of the highlights of him in goal, but he performed so, so well. And I just want to get it out to you that what a performance he had that last game. He really did help us out there. So apart from that, we do go and pick up a brand new kit for the team. West Ham United, it looks like quite a nice little kit there. Doesn't gel too well with the black kit onto the wave, but it's a nice fresh kit, because I was getting a bit bored of the Arsenal kit. Not being racist or anything to Arsenal, but I was getting a bit bored of their kit for the classic. And we go and pick up West Ham United kit, and looks to be a nice little kit for the team, and hopefully we can carry on. So as you can see here, we have got quite a few contract issues with the boys, so I go and sort them out. I've got to make a little statement to Henry, and I think Browning, yeah, that's right, in the centre backs. They've been performing really, really well for us in the two centre back positions, just been doing the job so, so well. And I just want to get out to them how well they're performing at the moment, so they get a couple of contracts to their names. Also, our midfielder gets a contract as well, and the striker, Mr. Riviera, did pick up an injury, guys, which I was absolutely pissed off about, because he had a really, really good game last game, and I'm pissed off that he does get injured. So we're going to swap Mr. Riviera out, and we're going to put him with Mr. Seagar. I'm hoping to God that Seagar can perform with Fraser Campbell. A nice bit of English connection there, which will help out very, very nicely. But still, it's Riviera. I want him on the pitch, because he's been taking his potatoes really nicely, and I'm hoping to go when he gets back he will carry on. But it's a pain in the ass having the Riviera up front, but I'm hoping Seagar can take the replacement really nicely, and obviously get a couple more goals while he's away. I think it's 2 games he's out for with a leg injury, but apart from that, that's the team right there, guys. It's not bad at all. We hope to start getting the premium silver, so please drop a comment, guys. What other premium silvers you want me to pick up? Anyone like a Bonlahor, Callum Wilson, you name it, guys, I'll get them for you. And we're going to make one hell of a side when it gets to a couple more episodes time. So please make sure to drop a like and a thumbs up, guys, if you've enjoyed the episode. And please make sure to check out the other episodes, guys, if you haven't seen all of them. The latest episode is out right now, and the first episode of this classic RTG is out right now. And that's all for, guys. I'll catch you guys later. Peace. Say that you want it all, but if you leave, you get